Hey guys, there is this scandal that I need to talk to you about. It's just emerging from Umkhonto weSizwe Party. Now, look, one of the leaders of Umkhonto weSizwe Party has been found on the wrong, allegedly because it has not yet been proven in the court of law. So anything that is not yet proven in the court of law, it remains allegedly. So as Is Sunday World had released an article. The heading of the article says MK leader Nyathi. It says leaders Nyathi bear all after breakup. This article was released by on Sunday World was released by Ubongani Mka. It was released by those words are very small, by the way, guys. So forgive me. It was released by Ubongani Mdagane. On the 21st of July, 2024, it speaks about the breakup that happened where that involves an MK party leader that sleeps or that was sleeping with somebody's wife. You know what I'm saying? It's funny. Let me give you a glimpse of it. It says, these people are very sarcasm here. It says, salacious details of steamy sexual lotion between a married MK party leader who cheated on his lawyer's wife with a tax consultant has emerged after the affair turned sour. Yabo, this thing is bad. You know, you're sleeping with Inyati and then it turns sour. Inyati, at the end of the day, you're not supposed to be angry. Guys, okay, yeah, that was about. Oh, yeah, but I you're supposed to defend the MK party. I was when. Hey, relax. Oh, I'm just doing my content things here. All right, relax. Relax. Nevertheless, okay, I'm joking, guys. But nevertheless, yeah. So there was this scandal that I need to talk to you about from MK party. Guys, let me warn you. There's no political party in South Africa that is without a scandal. Before you start commenting, telling me, do you know that most of the money stolen from VPS was stolen by people of the ANC, by the way? Now that they are making it an EFF thing, do you know that many people from the ANC stole that money? But again, they will not tell you because they want this to look like an EFF created problem. But okay, that's not where we are. I'm trying to say there's no political party without a problem, right? So before you start commenting and say, yes, Antola, hey, yeah, but naming in Tolile, this is what you need to do. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people, because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. All right, it's Sunday World, guys. Continue to say the second woman, Lerato Law, has since opened a case of fraud against Northwest MK Party provincial coordinator Zwelinzima Zibisa, who was number three on the party list of the provincial legislature. Law wants Zibisa to pay back 250,000 she claimed he swindled from her during their affair. Oof. I didn't get to this man. Hey, guys, I'm just asking. How did it get to this man? Hey, guys, Because Sunday World is telling us in Dabala. So now I'm for the worst, guys. Good. If you can charge 250,000, you know, from, you know what I'm saying, to Kanja. Now, if you don't get it, forget about it. Man, you're not supposed to get it anyway. Okay, so they continue to say. Zibisa's wife, Tsepi Zibisa, a lawyer and businesswoman who discovered the liaison through text messages sent to her husband, has accused the scorned Nyatsi of trying to kick her out of their children out of her matrimonial home. You see, this is the problem. You get into a relationship with a married person. I don't care whether that person is a female or male. It doesn't matter. The fact that once, in fact, by the way, let me put this disclaimer. Personally, as Bongan, the last thing I want to do in my life is to sleep with a married person. For me, I think that God is very, very specific. And I think there are more cases when you sleep with somebody's wife, because as a man, I'll sleep with a woman. You understand? I think there are more cases. I feel like for me, I wouldn't do it because it would bring a case to my life. So now that I've cleared that out of the way, here's a question that I want to ask you. How do you sleep with a person, somebody's wife or husband, and now you want to take over everything? The fact that they are married, isn't it supposed to tell you a lot? Number two, the fact that they dated you or slept with you, whatever you want to call it, that happens during that time, isn't it supposed to tell you that you are a second option? So if you're a second option, you must know that you'll always be a second option in their mind. So why would you want to take over? Three, why would you want to remove the wife and the children out of their matrimonial home? I'm not saying she did it, but I'm just saying to those who think it's a good thing to do, or you know what I'm saying, you're just showing supremacy of some sort, why would you do that? Let's continue. Sunday World has seen correspondence from Low to Zibisa praising him for his Olympic standard performance between the sheets. Hey, guys, about this stuff, 6'6", 6'6", or 9, whatever you want to take it, but the stuff is hot. You know what I'm saying? But then it was hot to a certain extent that, you know, it ended up going into the pocket and... Nyanbona, Nina. Nyanbona. Nyakbona, wena. Nyakbona. So, yeah. The message goes along these lines. Your love, I really enjoy you, baby. Let me repeat this one. Your love, I really enjoy you, baby. It comes from the girl. These are the text messages sent by the Nyatsi. You know, the guy Shorty has been extremely well on the bed. Continues to say, Sunday World, one of the messages sent to Sherby by Low, she boasted the wife will suffer a heart attack if she knew just how much money she had eaten from Zibisa. Another message from Low to Zibisa reads, I'm sorry for your hurt. I caused calling you a scam. Truly, I am sorry. In an affidavit she made opening the fraud case, which Sunday World has seen, she claims Zibisa convinced her to be his business partner few days after they had started sexual relationship. Hey, it must have been hot there. I'm telling you, it must have been hot. Le, hi. Bekshisa.
Nambona. Ingane ibonanga next. Mengithi mina ibonanga next. Angithi vumani phela. Vumani nita nibonanga next.
Aqhubeke. Low said Zivisa tried to get her to invest 150,000 rand in buying a taxi to be used for business venture at a mine. She eventually paid 50,000 instead of the amount requested. She said the text will start making payments after 3 months. He confirmed to me that the text has been purchased. She said on an affidavit. Law revealed that it's actually Siziba. Sorry, guys, I've been pronouncing the same name incorrectly. Siziba, not Zibisa, Siziba, who was also sleeping over at her pet in Midrand on weekend, approached her about another business deal. Low said towards the end of October 2023, Siziba asked her to make a provision of 134,442 secure a deal for branding of municipal vehicle. Low said she gave him a further 110,000 rand for another project to replace the batteries of municipal fleet. Low said she started getting concerned when payment from the supposed business deals were not coming through. She got the shock of her life when, after her own investigation, she was informed both mine and municipality that were never such a deal. All right. before I say anything, it must have been nice there, guys. Really, it must have been nice there. So when you decide to go separate ways, I don't want to say much, but you know what I'm saying. You know, bitterness parati the story. You know, petty parati. That's what I'm seeing. But let's continue. Low said towards the end of October 2023, Siziba had we've already covered that one. She started concerned when the money wasn't coming. She got a shock of her life when she started an investigation. We've done that one. She says, it is at this point when I realized that this guy had scammed me. I confronted him and kept on saying I did do business and I should be patient. Low and Siziba came up with excuses when she pressured him to pay back the money. Look, he then stopped communicating with her, prompting her to open a fraud case. Tsepi told Sunday World that she had a huge fight with her husband and after Low came into their home in Brett's Northwest. She once came here and told the security guard that my husband was her brother and that her mother had died. After she gained access to our property, I had a huge fight with Zweli and her. She was thrown out by the guards. In a video we have seen, Lo bare her soul, crying that she was lonely while Siziba was comfortable with his family. You know, something
that I don't understand. But I think too, like, one that don't blame anything me that.
Siziba admitted he had a relationship with Lo. I was in a relationship with Lerato, and she is lying that I scammed her. She used to lend me money, and I was also doing the same thing to her. Things went sour between us, and we drifted apart. I gave her a Toyota Quantum taxi that's worth 250,000 to pay her back the money she lent me. I gave her look 10,000, which was her look which she was having on birthday. Yeah. Hey, so you got your money, Mugel. What do you want? I'm telling you. Leng in chelela gatile. Ino pitanya. Ino. I don't know. Say much on this one. But I'm just telling you that le lenda ba le. Ino bu bitter ex. Ino bu bitter. If I can't have him, we're all not gonna have him. You know what I'm saying? Ino bu psychopath. Somewhere somehow.